Hello, hi everybody, this is Christopher with AG Productions, and today I am incredibly excited to announce the official release of our brand new DVD series, Masterpiece Miniatures, How to Create Your Own Miniature Works of Art. This DVD series has been in the works for a very long time. In fact, it started out as a book that I began writing on how to paint miniatures whenever I had downtime at the job I was working at way back in 2007. Over time, that book morphed into a much larger DVD set that was initially supposed to be 12 DVDs long. Since then, that DVD set has exploded and become something far more complex than I had ever imagined. Of the initial planned 12 DVDs, 5 of them have currently been filmed, and Volume 1 of Masterpiece Miniatures contains the first 3 of those DVDs. This new DVD series, Masterpiece Miniatures, is somewhat different than the series that you may be more familiar with, our Let's Paint DVD series, in that the Let's Paint DVD series really focuses on a single miniature and what strategies and techniques work best for painting that model, and then how to use those same techniques and strategies on any other miniature that you might want to paint. The goal of Masterpiece Miniatures is incredibly simple. It was designed to teach you literally everything I have ever learned about how to paint miniatures. As I said, Volume 1 contains 3 DVDs and runs just shy of 7.5 hours. It features examples and live demonstrations on over 50 different miniatures. Volume 1 of the Masterpiece Miniatures series was designed for the beginner in mind. It was designed to teach the beginner the basic foundational and fundamental techniques and skills that you would need to become a more advanced painter. Also included in Volume 1, you'll find several assignments that you'll be doing as you watch these DVDs. Those assignments have been designed specifically to help you become a more masterful painter. The pricing of this DVD set is going to be somewhat different than our Let's Paint DVD series. You can, if you wish, purchase each one of these DVDs separately. In other words, if you want, you can purchase just Disc 1, or just Disc 2, or just Disc 3. Now, each one of the DVDs is $15 each. Or you can buy all 3 of them together in this nice little carrying case for a low price of just $40. If you're interested in picking this set up, head over to our website, www.agpminis.com, and click on the link on the left-hand side of the page, How to Paint DVDs. Now, let's very quickly take a look at what is on each one of the 3 discs in this exciting new DVD set. Disc 1 is entitled Tools of the Trade, and it includes sections on paints, brushes, basing materials, conversion materials, preparation materials, and advanced materials. You'll find in-depth discussion on what kinds of paints work best for what purposes, a selection of what color paints you might want to start with so you don't overspend when you first get started in this hobby. You'll find a huge discussion of different basing materials that you can utilize with your miniatures. You'll see various types of saws, clippers, drills, files, and knives that you can use to prepare your models to be painted. You'll see several different types of glues that you can use to put your models together. A couple of different additives that you can put into your paint. You'll find information on masks as well as sealants that you can utilize once your miniatures are finished, as well as a slight discussion on cleaners that you can use to clean your brushes once you're finished painting your miniatures. Here is a quick clip from Disc 1 of Masterpiece Miniatures. These will give you good medium tone colors for all the primary colors. Now, the one you might be confused about is violet. Why not pick up purple instead? Let me show you. I'll move the other paints sort of out of the way. This is purple. You'd be surprised, but true purple is actually more pink than it is what we would normally consider purple, which is this right here. This is, I've just got little pieces here. You can actually buy full sheets of cork, and I've actually got some. I just don't have them right in front of me. But these are just little pieces that are left over from when I broke off some from the larger pieces. This is the largest piece I've got right here. But these work wonders for creating rock effects and rock textures on your bases. What we do is we take a little bit of this, and I'll just do a quick little demonstration here. In fact, I can probably do it with this small amount here. You just simply take a small amount of this, and you wrap it around the top of your needle nose pliers. And what that does is it just creates a nice cushiony barrier on the pliers that you can use to bend your models without damaging the models. Glue, when you use Instaset on the opposite piece that you put the glue on, will dry instantly. Okay? Now, another option that you can do, you can put the glue on one piece, you can put the two pieces together, and then you can spray Instaset sort of in between them, or at least onto the joint. That works just as well. Disc 2 is entitled Miniature Preparation and is my personal favorite of the three discs of Volume 1 of Masterpiece Miniatures. This DVD alone is worth the cost of the entire set just by itself. You'll find tons of information on Disc 2, including cleaning up a miniature, assembling a model, dealing with plastic minis, priming the miniature, and the awesome section Choosing a Miniature, which is something that most miniature painting instructors either skim over or completely ignore entirely. You'll find invaluable insight in this DVD on how to pick an appropriate miniature to learn how to paint, two different methods for searching for a miniature to paint, as well as information on how to make sure that you prepare yourself mentally to create the best-looking miniature possible. You'll learn how to remove flashing and mold lines from both metal and plastic minis, as well as the best and most effective way to use a hobby knife. You'll learn when to assemble a miniature prior to painting versus after you paint the miniature. Also, how to effectively attach a miniature to a base depending upon the type of the model as well as the type of the base. You'll learn how to position a miniature on the base for maximum aesthetic effect, how and why to test fit your miniatures together, a great section on how to pin a miniature, how to effectively glue two flat surfaces together without them coming apart. You'll also have a really nice section here on how to fill the gaps on a miniature, as well as how to match the texture of a miniature once a gap has been filled. You'll learn the best way to prime your miniatures, and I do mean the best way. How to tell if you're priming correctly or not. In other words, what a good and a badly primed miniature looks like, as well as information on utilizing both spray and brush-on primer. Here's a quick peek at Disc 2 of Masterpiece Miniatures. Now, the other thing that you might want to note about polystyrene cement is this. Whenever you use it, it forms what I like to refer to as strings. For instance, if I were to put glue onto this model's foot here, if I can get some out of the tube, there we go, there's a little bit there, a little bit there. Okay, you see, possibly, do you see the string that's like right there that's running, well now it's running to my finger, but these little strings of plastic glue, your type of any sort of cleanup that you'll need to do on a metal model, is to remove what's known as flashing. Flashing is sort of a metallic skin that forms between two pieces of a metal model. You can see it here on this dragon. Let me get my hobby knife out. It's sort of a pointer. You can see right here between the smaller horn and the larger horn, there's this tiny little flap of metallic skin. Establish an internal skeleton within that miniature in order to give it more strength and stability at the joints. For instance, if we were attaching a hand to a wrist, what we would do is we would take our pen vise and we would drill a hole into the wrist right here. And so this would be a nice open area. We would also drill a hole in the corresponding area of the hand. Into this, we would insert a piece of paperclip or brass rod, whatever you would like to use. Really, only two different types of skin that you're going to have. You're going to have, generally speaking, smooth skin, or you're going to have rough skin, okay? And much like this, you can see right here, that sort of looks like the skin up here, alright? See how it's kind of rough up here? Kind of rough down here as well. When that's covered over with primer and then with paint,
My guess is that that area, it's going to be very difficult to tell that that was ever, ever any kind of green stuff at all. More than likely, when you see that, once it's fully painted, it's going to look exactly like it was part of the model from the very beginning.
Now, Disc 3 is entitled The Classic Method, and if you will remember, I said that the main goal of the Masterpiece Miniatures series was to teach you literally everything I had ever learned as a miniature painter. Many years ago, I learned how to paint by using the Classic Method, and many other miniature painters have as well. It's a great way to learn the foundational and fundamental skills and techniques that you'll need when you want to paint even more advanced miniatures in the future. Included in Disc 3, you'll find information on what to do before you paint your miniatures, how to base coat, shade, and highlight your models, and how to deal with details on your miniatures. You'll learn how to properly hold your brushes. You'll learn how to hold the miniature. You'll learn how to steady your hands, arms, and breathing so that your painting is as smooth as it possibly can be. How to get your paints to mix effectively. How to utilize a palette. And how to choose an appropriate brush size, as well as common mistakes to avoid when choosing a brush to paint your miniatures with. What to focus on when base coating. The easiest way to base coat your miniatures when you first begin the hobby. An introduction to what I call the tone scale, one of the most important tools that you will ever see in miniature painting instruction. Making sure that your paint is the appropriate thickness. The best way to manipulate the brush while painting your miniatures. You'll find several speed tips to make your painting even faster. You'll learn how to clean and shape your brush as you switch from one color paint to the next, as well as how to locate and fix all kinds of mistakes that you might have made on your miniatures. You'll see tons of different 2D and 3D illustrations and examples, the differences between a paint and an ink wash, how to create a paint wash, three different methods of shading a miniature, how to fix mistakes, the best colors to use when shading other colors, and the differences between both thick and thin washes. You'll also learn about the best colors to utilize when highlighting other colors, how, why, and when to dry brush, how to paint a highlight onto a miniature, how to deal with metallic paints, painting weapons, both fantasy and futuristic, painting armor, plate mail, scale mail, and chain mail, and the keen sense of developing an awareness of when to stop highlighting. You'll learn how to paint eyes, how to varnish and seal your miniatures, and finally you'll learn how to base your miniatures at a very basic level. Here is a small excerpt from Disc 3 of Masterpiece Miniatures. This would be considered painting a clean line twice. What we want to do is we want to get used to painting a clean line only once. And this is very difficult for some people because as we were growing up, many of us who had coloring books and things like that were taught always stay inside the lines. Well, the problem with staying inside the lines on miniature painting is that it slows down your painting. So allow me to demonstrate painting a clean line only one time. All right, I'll take my blue once again. And let's say that, again, I'm painting that cloak. What I would do is I would take the blue, I would paint the cloak, and then I would just shade ink wash. The archer on the left has been shaded using the wash straight out of the bottle, while the archer on the right has been shaded using the wash that's been thinned down with a little bit of water. As you can tell, the archer on the right, whose ink wash was thinned with a little bit of water, has much lighter shading than the archer on the left. These two archers have been shaded using a paint wash that I created. As you can see, the archer on the left has a much thicker paint wash than the one on the right. I will caution you that if you decide to, for instance, on this upper shoulder pauldron here, I might highlight in this area. And you'll see a marked difference in the two colors. And it works really, really well. And what we'll do after this is we'll come back and we'll put on just a very, very small highlight of a really bright silver color just on the top edges. And what that will do is it will really bring that three-dimensionality out of the figure and really, really make it pop.
To add the pupils, we're simply going to add in a dot of black. I've got some black here ready to go. I've got some in my brush. And it's just a matter of coming in and being very, very careful and placing a tiny dot right in the center of the eye. Just like that. Let me do the other one as well. There we go.
I hope that you've enjoyed this preview of Masterpiece Miniatures Volume 1. Again, if you want to pick this set up, head over to our website, www.agpminis.com. That's all for today, guys. God bless you all. Have a wonderful rest of the day, and I will see you all in the next video.